हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू। इन टुडे सेशन वी विल बी टॉक अबाउट द पोएम नाइट ऑफ द स्कॉर्पियो बाय निसन एज़ाकर। सो बिफोर मूविंग अहेड टू द पोएम, फर्स्ट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द ब्रीफ इंट्रो ऑफ द पोइट हियर, हु इज निसन एज़ाकर। He was an Indian Jewish poet, playwright, editor, as well as an art critic. Ezekiel was a Jew by birth and he belonged to the Bene Israel community. He completed his bachelor's in literature from Wilson College, Mumbai in 1947. And during 1947 to 48, he taught English literature and published literary articles in various magazines. After being politically active in India, he sailed to England in November 1948. He studied philosophy at Birkbeck College in London. After returning to India, he joined the Illustrated Weekly of India as an assistant editor in 1953 and stayed there for 2 years. And he was also the head of the Department of English in Mithibhai College, Mumbai from 1961 to 1972. He rendered his service as a visiting professor at University of Leeds and University of Chicago as well. His poetic collections include the very first collection of poems was A Time to Change, which was published in 1952. And there are other works as well. 60 poems, The Unfinished Man, The Exact Name, Hints in Darkness, Later Day Silence, etc. He was awarded the Sahitya Akademi Award in 1983 for his poetry collection Later Day Slums and the Padma Shri in 1988. He died in Mumbai on January 9, 2004. Now moving ahead to the poem, let us talk a brief about the background of the poem. In Night of the Scorpio, Nizam Ezekiel is recounting a past event, the past event of his life, when at night when his mother was stung by a scorpion. And the reaction of the peasants, his father and his mother also to that. So while the peasants who enveloped in their superstitions, prayers, when they chanted for the recovery of his mother, and the efforts done by his father, who was a skeptic or rationalist, as presented by the speaker here, and who used every kind of remedies, and there was also a holy man who performed various kind of rituals to cure the pain of his mother. So all these kind of typical Indian village setting which has been presented by the speaker here. And very first, this poem Night of the Scorpio, actually it appeared in the collection entitled Exact Name, which was published in 1965, as we earlier have talked about this. So actually the whole poem is a picture of an ordinary day in rural Indian life. So the poem is written in free verse, as we don't find any kind of rhyme structure or metrical patterns in the poem. So it is very natural in tone, and so we can find so many things here. Now let's start the text. Here we are. I am reading for you. I remember the night my mother was stung by a scorpion. 10 hours of steady rain had driven him to crawl beneath a sack of rice. So here the speaker is describing a particular event of his past life. He is actually recalling the past incident in the beginning, where the poet says that he distinctly remembers the night when his mother was stung by a scorpion, and 10 hours of steady rain had driven him to crawl beneath a sack of rice. So here it had been raining. 10 hours of steady rain means regular or incessantly. So it had been raining incessantly for 10 hours, and the excessive rainfall forced the Scorpio to take shelter under a big bag or sack of rice. So the Scorpio who had gone away after inflicting the poison into the speaker's mother's body. And then what happened here? I'm reading the text. Parting with his poison flask of diabolic tale in the dark room, he risked the rain again. So all of a sudden, when after the Scorpio stung his mother, he quickly left its poison in her body, and it instinctively fled the spot and went away into the rains. So poison flash means a sudden burst of light, a quick moment of diabolic tale in the dark room. So diabolic, this metaphor is used here. The poet actually establishes the Scorpio as a symbol of evil, who has the diabolic feature characteristics. So diabolic means giant like or evil like characteristics here. So diabolic means cruel, who is very cunning and wicked. So the Scorpio is given these kind of characteristics, that he has diabolic tail and who has inflicted poison into the speaker's mother's body. And after then he risked the rain again, means he moved quickly away into the rain. And next, the peasants came like swarms of fleas and burst the name of God 100 times to paralyze the evil one. Once this incident happened, then there are several other peasants and who stay nearby neighborhood of the speaker or of the poet. That and what was the reaction of these rural illiterate peasants, that after knowing the incident, they came like as a swarms of fleas. So here the rhetorical device seemingly has been used by the poet, as we come to know that the word like swarms of fleas. So here this phrase suggests that the peasants, they are compared to the like swarms of fleas. When they came in large number, swarms of fleas, this particular phrase suggests that the peasants came in large numbers or in large number of groups. So after knowing the incident, a large number of village people and mostly peasants, they thronged the poet's home. And what did they do? And burst the name of God 100 times. So here the burst means this phrase suggests that they burst, the peasants, they burst or they made a humming sound. Here it means the sound produced when the peasants started chanting the name of God in a low voice at the same time. So they all started praying to God to spare her life, to spare the life of speaker's mother. So to paralyze the evil one. In order to stop the Scorpio's moving, means to paralyze the evil one. Here, the poet is using the metaphor evil one. The rhetorical device metaphor is used here. The evil one, who is the evil one here? The Scorpio. So here the metaphor evil is used for the Scorpio, who has the demonic characteristics. Who is the demon here? Who is the evil one here? So to paralyze the evil one means to stop the Scorpio from moving by using the capitals E here, E-O in evil or O in one. The poet actually has established the Scorpio as a symbol of evil. So after that, with candles and with lanterns, throwing giant Scorpio shadows on the mud-backed walls, they searched for him. So in order to stop the Scorpio from moving, the villagers searched for it with lanterns and candles. And when they are busy in searching for the Scorpio, so their shadows were formed on the walls, which were Scorpio like. So the giant shadows of the villagers has been characterized as the giant the shadow of Scorpio. They were seeming giant like Scorpio. The poet actually ironically suggests that the human beings are more dangerous than scorpions. Their shadows look like scorpions, only much bigger. And after that, they searched for him. He was not found. The villagers, they tried very much, but they could not found the Scorpio there. Then they clicked their tongues. With every movement that the Scorpio made, his poison moved in mother's blood, they said. So here they clicked their tongues. It means they after their efforts they made short sharp sounds with their tongues as a gesture of sympathy for the poet's mother. They make illogical sounds, clicked their tongues. After all their efforts, when the Scorpio was not to be seen anywhere, they all showed great sympathy for the mother, and they said that with very moment of the Scorpio, the poison spread in mother's blood. So this line actually shows that the peasants, they were very superstitious, and they did not know, they did not have any knowledge as to so scorpion bite can be cured. So here the illiterate superstitious nature of those illiterate peasants has been described by the poet. Now moving ahead, here we are. May he sit still, they said. May the sins of your previous birth be burned away tonight, they said. May your suffering decrease the misfortunes of your next birth, they said. May the sum of all evil balanced in this unreal world. So now moving ahead, here they prayed that the Scorpio should not move. May he be sit still here. The villagers, they said that may the Scorpio be sit still here. The Scorpio should not move. And they wished that the mother's pain, unbearable pain and suffering, should wash away the sins of her previous birth. And simultaneously, they should also diminish the grievances of her next birth. So here these lines suggest the Indian, typical Indian karma theory, and these villagers seem to believe in the karma theory, the philosophy of karma, where an individual has to bear the consequences of his past birth and his next birth also. So the peasants believe that there is nearly as much evil in this world as there is good. So the peasants are trying to justify the situation in their own way. They say that purify your the suffering of her mother through poisonous effect of that bite of Scorpio, that they believe that it is okay because his mother must have committed some kind of sins, maybe in her previous birth. So this is a kind of compensate, and it will be okay by the time her suffering period will go, then her misfortunes of her next birth will also go. So the sum of all evil balanced in this unreal world. So they believe that there are as much evil in this world as much goodness is prevail. So the suffering of the poet's mother would destroy a part of that evil. Against the sum of good become diminished by your pain. So they thought that, they believe that evil would become less and there would be more good than evil in balance. So the pain of mother will be diminished by the time when the evil, when the effect of that evil be reduced down. And next they are saying, may the poison purify your flesh of desire and your spirit of ambition. So here the peasants raise the fundamental issue regarding the nature of reality and the roles of good and evil in life, that there is two things, there is this binary of goodness and evil in each and every individual, and that the peasants, they started praying by saying that the suffering caused by this poison should purify her from worldly desires and ambitions. They sat around the mother